fire crews across the West are preparing for strong winds today and the possibility that they will further fuel what's already considered one of the worst fire seasons on record. At least 35 people have died in wildfires across California, Oregon, and Washington state. Officials describe the conditions as apocalyptic. And flames aren't the only thing threatening lives. Smoke is exposing millions of people to dangerously bad air quality, stretching all the way to Canada. CBS News' Laura Podesta has the latest.
The Bobcat Fire forced mandatory evacuations yesterday as it moved closer to homes north of Los Angeles. Greg Vanney isn't sure if his 100-year-old cabin in the San Gabriel Mountains survived.
It's like the seven plagues, biblical sense.
The raging wildfires have burned thousands of structures up and down the West Coast and left everywhere from California to Canada with dangerously bad air quality.
It looks kind of post-apocalyptic, actually. It's kind of spooky.
In Northern California, the North Complex fire has killed more than a dozen people.
My mom was a really cool chick.
Holly Katarancic's mother, Millicent, is among the victims.
When I didn't hear from her when I woke up, I knew something was wrong. I knew that if my mom had gotten out, she would have called us immediately.
Today, President Trump attends a briefing with Cal Fire in Sacramento County.
I think he needs to go in and see what's going on and see the destruction that's happening.
The president addressed the wildfires last night at a rally in Nevada.
Like the biggest we've ever had. It's crazy. It's crazy what's going on. Thousands and thousands and thousands of acres. It's crazy.
Jay Inslee, the Democratic governor of Washington, said President Trump needs to take climate change more seriously.
And these people whose homes were destroyed that I've seen with their tears in the last few days, they deserve action against climate change.
In Oregon, more than 1 million acres burned last week alone, double compared to a typical year. Laura Podesta, CBS News.
Kara Finnstrom from our Los Angeles station is live near the front lines in Arcadia, California, where the Bobcat Fire is burning, and she joins us now. So, Kara, so far, more than 33,000 acres have been scorched by the flames, forcing people to flee their homes. Describe what you're seeing there on the ground.
Well, we've been watching an orange glow across the ridgetops behind us all morning, but the smoke has now gotten so thick that you can't see it any longer. And that's thick smoke, a concern for folks here, as well as the fire today. We can tell you that we're near a command post. We saw hotshot crews roll out a short while ago. Aggressive air attacks have also been taking place on this fire. We're in Arcadia, right up in the foothills, and this is the area where those evacuations were ordered yesterday. Hundreds of people asked to leave. Numerous other foothill communities under evacuation warnings as well. They will be watching and waiting. This fire has continued to move southward, coming down some hillsides, and that's the concern for these communities.
And so then moving forward today and maybe over the next couple of days, are conditions expected to get worse, or maybe Mother Nature will help out a little?
Well, there is some concern with the winds. The winds have been great for moving out the smoke. It's still thick, but it not as bad as it was yesterday. However, those winds can actually fuel, of course, that fire spread. So they're going to be watching to see what happens with that throughout the day.
And Kara, officials in California, Oregon, and Washington have called in for help. What kind of resources do they have at hand? I know that last week we were reporting that resources were stretched thin. What's the situation now?
They are stretched thin. You know, the report was from Cal Fire that we have seen more acreage burn during the first 9 months of this year than during any other year altogether. So those resources stretched out all across the state. We know that the Antonov aircraft, pretty exciting here, it's the world's largest, arrived in San Francisco yesterday with some more fire engines as well. The National Guard has been called in. And in addition to all the support that is now starting to come in federally, other agencies in neighboring states are sending in help too. So all of that adding up to try and take some stress off of these firefighters who have been working now for days, more than a week, on these fires.
And they will get a chance to talk to the president. President Trump is meeting with Cal Fire today. What can we expect from that?
He's going to get a tour of some of those damaged areas, be brought up to date on what the fire is doing right now. Of course, as we just heard in the report that aired, there is some debate underway as to what part climate change may play in all of this. And the president has specifically raised some concerns about the management of national forest areas. So that will definitely be discussed today as they decide the best way to move forward.
Over the weekend, the president blamed the wildfires on California's bad forest management. I want to play a bit of that.
Really haven't. They never had anything like this. But, you know, it is about forest management. Please remember the words. Very simple. Forest management. Please remember. It's about forest management and other things, but forest management.
So here's something important to note. Much of the land that is burning in the state, Kara, as you know, is federally owned. So what has the Trump administration done in terms of fire response and suppression and land management?
Well, we know some federal aid is headed this way, but that's exactly what's being underlined by a lot of the authorities here. And CAL FIRE officials really stressing that their crews on the ground have never seen anything like the fire behavior they're seeing now, that these long stretches of extremely dry periods have allowed the conditions to be such that these fires are spreading at an unprecedented rate. So that has less to do, they say, with the fact that there is fuel out there than these conditions that exist, which are just driving the spread, again, at an unprecedented rate.
Unprecedented indeed. Kara Finnstrom, thank you so much.